After you've removed the contents from the home and open up the walls, you'll see areas of mold typically. There'll be other contaminants from the flood waters. You want to use water initially to get off as much of that, just physically remove it with water. Then after that, you can use a water detergent solution. You want to read the label on that product and make sure you have the right amount of that can be used for that as well. But those products, the detergent products, will be more effective if you do that initial washing with the water and then come back later with a detergent type solution. We usually use a two bucket type system. You can use any number of different brushes, but we have a solution in one bucket, a clean solution, and then a rinse bucket in the other, and that is a more efficient way of cleaning. You can use pressure washing during the process, but using a high pressure washing system sometimes can be cause more damage than good. So you want to be aware of using not too high of a pressure water. And then lastly, you could consider using a bleach type solution to sanitize, but in most cases, removing the mold is the important aspect of it. It's not just enough to kill the mold, you have to physically remove the mold. And that's your main focus when you're trying to get into this cleaning process. When you use different cleaners or detergents, make sure you take a look at the product and read the label. It'll give you an idea what the different concentrations are and how it can be used. And so that's an important aspect when you get into the clean out phase, trying to remove some of the mold and other water contaminants that came from the floodwaters. If you sanitize with a bleach solution, you can use a common spray bottle to do that, but it's important to keep the surface wet for about 5 minutes or more. And so you can use systems like this, which are a little more efficient at doing that. Sometimes it helps you get into cracks and crevices better as well. And so those can be important tools to use in the sanitizing process. The other note to make on sanitizing is that the bleach type solutions tend to be more effective on non-porous surfaces like bathtubs, for example. On wood, it just because of all the porous nature of the wood, it's a semi-porous material, it tends to be less effective at killing microorganisms. So keep that in mind as you go through and sanitize your home. And always read the label on that to get the appropriate concentration and use the product in a way that's going to be effective.